Hey guys, it's Chris. History is full of dark things. Be careful what you look for, because treasures sometimes come with curses. From lost tombs to family tragedy, here are 8 mysterious historical curses. Number 8. Ötzi, the Iceman. In 1991, 2 German tourists were going along the mountain pass on Haslabjok when they came across a frozen body. Now, at first, they thought it was the body of a hiker, like them, who had gotten trapped in the snow. But it turns out it was something far more unique. Not only did they find a mummy, they found Europe's oldest and naturally found mummy at 5,300 years old. So what does that mean? It means that nature preserved it, not a process by man. The Iceman was later called Ötzi, named after the mountain in the Alps. So where's the curse part? Well, many of the people who examined Ötzi after being found have died. For example, there was Rainer Henn, who died via an auto accident. Kurt Fritz died in an avalanche. Helmut Simon, who was the man who found Ötzi, died while hiking. And the man who led the rescue time to try to get Simon died shortly after his funeral. Many feel that Ötzi was cursed and wasn't meant to be taken off that mountain. Others, however, point out that there were hundreds of people who touched or examined Ötzi, and so for only a handful of them to die doesn't really mean anything. Number 7. The Madden Curse. Some curses take different forms. Some like to kill, others torture, and for the Madden curse, it makes sure that the person on the cover does badly the next year. This may seem like a childish curse, but there is a lot of merit to it when you look at certain athletes. And for those who don't know, the Madden NFL games are the most popular football games around. Every year they sell millions of copies, and the reveal of the cover athlete is a really big deal, as it shows that the person on the cover was one of the most impactful players of the previous year. But for a while, and arguably continuing to this day, there were a string of cover athletes who went from top dogs to bottom feeders, or worse, injured, or far worse than that, soon left the game. Confirmed recipients of this curse are Michael Vick, who was on Madden 2004, Donovan McNabb, who was on Madden 2006, Sean Alexander on 2007, Vince Young on Madden 2008, Brett Favre on 2009, Troy Polamalu on Madden 2010, and Peyton Hills on 2012. Heck, even if you look at recent covers, Tom Brady was the cover athlete of Madden 2018, and he lost the Super Bowl to a backup quarter in the Eagles. And this year, Antonio Brown of the Steelers is the cover athlete. Last year, he was the most explosive receiver in the NFL. And now, through 6 games, he has only 6 touchdowns and he has less than 500 yards receiving. It may seem objective, but the numbers don't lie. Number 6. King Casimir's Tomb. In 1973, the tomb of the late King Casimir was found, and not long after that, people started to die. 4 of the 12 people who uncovered the tomb were dead within days. More died in the years to come. Things continued to escalate until no fewer than 15 people were killed because of this, all of whom worked or studied the tomb of the Polish king. The rumors started to spread, the tomb was cursed. However, after some research, the curse was debunked, and in doing this gave more context as to how King Casimir had been buried. For after he had been embalmed, the people charged with sealing the tomb did so very poorly. In fact, it was a literal rush job. The seal on the coffin wasn't complete, and so rain and other elements caused the corpse to decompose in a very bad way, creating a deadly fungus called Aspergillus flavus. So when the team opened the coffin, the fungus spread to them, and they all started to die. Number 5. Kennedy Curse. The name Kennedy is synonymous with power and politics. The Kennedy family has a long-standing history of being in politics, and their most famous member, John F. Kennedy, was President of the United States. However, with his death in 1963, bad things started to happen to the family. A curse was born from his death. Robert Kennedy, brother to JFK, was also assassinated, this time in 1968. Senator Ted Kennedy, who was one of the few not affected by the curse in terms of dying himself, once drove his car off a bridge, killing a woman in the process. He also survived a plane crash. Both of Robert Kennedy's sons died, one from an overdose and the other in a skiing accident. John F. Kennedy Jr., his wife, and his wife's sister all died in a plane crash. And even Mary Kennedy, who was the wife of Robert Kennedy Jr., hanged herself. And there's no rhyme or reason to these deaths outside of them happening all to one family. Thus, the curse is said to be real. And it's hard to deny the possibility when it's all laid out like that. Number 4. Curse of Tippecanoe. The President of the United States is said to be cursed with power. But in the case of the curse of Tippecanoe, that curse took a new meaning. This all started with President William Harrison, who led the American forces against Native American leader Tecumseh at the titular Tippecanoe. Ever since William Harrison became president in 1840, every 20 years, a president who was elected would be assassinated. Harrison was first, and he didn't even last a month as president. In 1860, Abe Lincoln was elected, and he was killed 5 years later. In 1880, James Garfield was elected and later assassinated. Same with William McKinley in 1900 after he was elected. Warren G. Harding in 1920 and Franklin Delano Roosevelt in 1940 both died when they were in the presidency. Of natural causes, but still during their terms. John F. Kennedy was elected in 1960 and he too was assassinated. The curse was finally broken in 1980, after Ronald Reagan was shot but not killed during an assassination attempt. To prove that the curse was broken, George H.W. Bush was elected in 2000, and he had no such attempts on his life, and he is still alive today. Number 3. Curse of the Billy Goat. Chicago Cubs fans know this story very well, as it was a curse that haunted for over 70 years, and only recently was it broken. This all started with a man from Illinois named William C. Annis, who just happened to own the Billy Goat Tavern in Chicago. The city was in a state of frenzy because the Chicago Cubs were in the World Series. William decided to get a ticket for Game 4, and he got another as well, but not for a friend, rather for his Billy Goat. Now, the legend is a bit vague as to whether William made it to the ballpark and was asked to leave because of the Billy Goat, or he was turned away at the door because Wrigley Field wouldn't allow the goat in. Either way, he said, "Them Cubs, they ain't gonna win no more." Sure enough, the Cubs lost that game and the World Series. And for the next 71 years, the Cubs didn't make it to the World Series. Until finally, in 2016, they won, and in dramatic fashion. The previous Cubs victory in the World Series had come in 1908, so the Cubs had over 100 years of World Series victory droughts, and every time the Cubs seemed to be getting close to achieving victory, something would happen to stop them. But now they're free, and they know better than to insult a goat who has a ticket. Number 2. Curse of the Pharaoh. In terms of curses, the curse of the Pharaoh, which was said to have been wrought upon the people who opened the tomb of King Tutankhamun, is one of the most legendary and one of the most infamous. It's said that the people who opened the tomb were slowly killed off, one by one, for opening the sacred relic. In fact, some people think it was the gods themselves who punished them. That may sound ominous, but there is a little bit of truth in here. For in the decade after the opening of the tomb in 1923, 6 of the 23 people present died, and some in very weird ways, which helped fuel the curse, including blood poisoning and dying from a disease via a mosquito. Via these deaths, the curse of the Pharaoh was born. The media grabbed onto the story and it spread throughout the world. While some still fear the curse to this day, there have been new facts brought to life that cast doubt on the curse. For example, there's no mention in Egyptian lore of such a curse. Warnings, yes, but no curses. Furthermore, there are theories that it was ancient biological pathogens that got some of these people killed, which would make sense as they would be preserved in the tomb, and the bodies of the archaeologists would not have proper immunity for them. So once some of them were exposed, they succumbed to them eventually. Finally, it was revealed that the idea for the curse was put forth by one of the heads of the expedition team in order to ward off tomb raiders. And to that point, tomb raiding of these tombs were indeed deterred because of the curse. Whether it's real or not is up for debate. And this is one mystery and legend that will last as long as the pyramids themselves. Number 1. The Hope Diamond. The legendary Hope Diamond has had many names. But the one that ties it to history the most is the name of cursed object. Though this blue diamond, measured to be 45 carats, is worth approximately $250 million, it is believed to be cursed. So much so that people refuse to touch the diamond. Why? Well, just about everyone who comes into contact with the diamond either has great misfortune fall upon them or they die. As in all things, this starts with the diamond in its original setting. A temple in India. A Hindu priest stole the gem and later died an agonizing death. Eventually, the gem was found in the Golconda mines and made its way to Europe around 1642. There, it was bought by a French merchant, who would eventually sell it to King Louis XIV. That merchant was later mauled to death by dogs. Both King Louis and his wife Marie Antoinette were later beheaded, and the gem was stolen during that period. The gem continued to move around, being given to various owners, including a potential encounter with a British king whose family had to sell the diamond to pay off his debts. Eventually, it wound up in the hands of a man named Henry Thomas Hope, which is where the diamond eventually got its name. Several owners after him followed, and a similar tale of death and woe continued. But the question that has plagued history is the one of whether this curse is true. Some believe it, and vehemently so. Yet others aren't so sure, mainly because this was considered to be a hoax by journalists to help make the Hope Diamond more valuable and intriguing, a ploy that would even be used today. Another theory on this subject is that it was people seeking to blame their troubles on something other than themselves, and the Hope Diamond was just a scapegoat. The debate on the curse is very real, with both sides having clear evidence to say why they're right. But whatever you believe, the Hope Diamond is not cursing anyone anymore, as it was donated to the Smithsonian in 1958, where it remains to this day in a glass case, making sure no one can touch it. Thanks for watching! What did you think of these curses? What do you think? Are some of them real? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe to Worldlist, and I'll see you next time.